Am I a candidate for a hair transplant? Am I balding? Hello, I'm a 33-year-old man. My father is not bald but has a high hairline. I too have a high hairline. However, I recently have been told my hair appears to be thinning on my crown area. I'm not sure if it indeed is, or if it's simply too much hair product put into my hair. Attached is a picture. My grandfather was bald and I'm concerned it might increase. If it's indeed a problem, how can I gauge it, and would a hair transplant fix it? Thanks.
Thank you for your question. You're 33 years old, and you've asked, are you a candidate for transplant, and are you balding? And you've provided for us some information about your family history. So these are actually two separate questions, but let's start with the main question, which is, are you balding? Are you losing hair? And although you've sent only one limited photo, it is relatively clear on that photo that the crown to the central area of your scalp appears to be thin. Now, it is possible that hair products like gels can make hair look a little bit thinner because of the clumping that can happen, but at the same time, it is not unusual for someone in their early 30s to start losing hair. There is a general rule of thumb that we use in the hair restoration world, and it is basically the rule of decades, and this is specifically for male pattern hair loss. So in your 20s, only about 20% of men are losing hair. In the 30s, 30%, and it increases with every decade. So you have an opportunity to make some decisions about how to manage your hair loss. Something that we cannot predict is the rate of the progression. You see, hair loss, male pattern hair loss, is often very bewildering, and there's all kinds of rumors about how to predict your own future, such as using the rule of the maternal uncle as being the person who determines your future for hair loss. That's actually not true. It's not the maternal uncle. It's actually a set of genes that are variably expressed. So it makes it very, very difficult. Within the same family, several siblings, several brothers can all have very different patterns of hair loss. It can be frustrating and bewildering. So, assuming that you are also aware that besides looking at pictures, but also your own feel, that you are thinning, you have some options as far as what to do, and you don't necessarily have to go straight to hair transplantation. So let's understand a little bit about the options. For male pattern hair loss in the United States, there are two drugs that are FDA cleared specifically for hair loss. One is minoxidil, which is such as the trade name Rogaine, a topical application which can improve the appearance of hair that is thinning. It doesn't reverse the hair loss, but it appears to thicken some hairs, as well as prolong the growth cycle of the hair so that when your hair, there's more hair around, it looks a little bit thicker. The other drug is finasteride, which goes by the trade name Propecia. Finasteride is a drug that inhibits an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase, which is responsible for the conversion of testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. Now, this is based on an understanding of hair follicles having something called androgen receptors and the sensitivity of those androgen receptors to dihydrotestosterone. Now, there is a lot that we don't know about the behavior of hair follicles, and that's what makes the hair loss treatment process so limited in so many ways. For several decades, universities and private companies have been working on identifying the key cells and signals necessary for hair growth. And I think one of the things that people are realizing is that what may have been a puzzle that people thought 30 years ago was 1,000 pieces is actually closer to 1,000,000 pieces. And so there's a lot of research going on, and every year to 2 years you hear about something new that is found in a university, and we stay on top of that information. But unfortunately, the dream of hair cloning or growing hair follicles in the lab so that they can be transplanted, in terms of clinical world, is not we're not close to being there yet. In our practice, we have had a great opportunity to develop a process called hair regeneration. Now, this happened to be a serendipitous discovery where a material called extracellular matrix was used to help improve the healing of a transplanted area, as well as to improve the growth of the transplanted hair follicles. And at the same time, it appeared to thinning hair. So what we've developed over the past couple of years is a method of injection treatment where we're able to treat hair loss or hair thinning and thickening hair using this extracellular matrix and platelet-rich plasma, which is your own blood that is spun and concentrated the areas known as the platelets and the plasma to maximize the effect of this extracellular matrix. Now, this has changed tremendously how we manage our patients who are having hair loss. So you have options. First, a few years ago, if someone had come to us, we would have first said, let's start with medical treatment, and they would make an informed decision. Now, currently, there have been a lot of concerns about the sexual side effects of finasteride, and so a lot of younger men who are coming to us in their 20s and 30s are just not interested in taking finasteride. Ironically, we have men in their 50s and 60s who've been taking finasteride since 1997, 98 when it first came out, and they have had no side effects and they're very happy. So it's important to make informed decisions and at least get the information and make that decision. Many of our patients who, like yourself, are in their 30s and come to us with thinning hair and who don't want to take finasteride and are balancing the options of choosing a hair transplant, ultimately choose hair regeneration as their preferred option. And there's a couple of reasons for that. For one thing, it's an injection. It's not a transplant surgery. So surgery versus injection, you know, it's a pretty easy decision to make. But also, there's an understanding that although you can get a hair transplant, that hair transplant is only the permanent hairs or the hairs that don't thin being transplanted to areas that are thinning. Hair transplantation does not stop progression of hair thinning. So we see men who have come to us who have had multiple hair transplants and they've lost their existing thinning hairs and are left with only the transplants. And that's what people always identify as a transplanted look or the pluggy look. And it keeps a lot of people from even considering hair transplantation. So what we're doing is we're using this hair regeneration technology. We've been treating people with thinning hair, and with about 3 to 5 years of data behind us, we're not needing to repeat this injection. There are the occasional patients that we do a repeat injection on, but we see people very carefully. We will follow them with microscopy as well as with the digital photography to watch their progress after we do their injection. So if you were to come to our practice or someone like you, then we would probably guide you towards considering hair regeneration and avoiding transplantation. By saving the hairs, you are able to thicken up those thin hairs that will fill a lot more effectively than any hair transplant can. We can't duplicate with transplantation what nature creates naturally. So this wonderful extracellular matrix technology has serendipitously helped us reverse hair thinning and thickening hair with the hair regeneration. So in your position, I would probably not choose transplantation and learn about the medical options as well as the option for hair regeneration. So I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.